Hello world, I'm Daryl from MakeCode, and today we're going to learn how to add power-ups to our game. So the game we've got going so far, this has been built during the space shooter video, which I'll link down to in the description. And so the game we have currently, you've got a spaceship, it's going around and you can shoot it down other spaceships, which we get some points for, and also we avoid colliding with those spaceships. However, it would be exciting if when you shot down these other spaceships, maybe the player got some reward occasionally, like a power-up. Maybe their gun fired faster or something of that sort. And there's many different contexts and different games in which you can have power-ups, but often the basic ideas are the same. There's usually some way that power-ups are dropped, and then they have some effect on the player. So in our case, we're going to go look at where the enemies are destroyed. So there's two ways for an enemy to be destroyed, either when they run into the player or when their health bar reaches zero. So in these cases, we want to add a certain chance that a power-up is dropped. So what I'm going to do is use a function to handle the code when an enemy dies. So I'm going to go to the advanced section here and click functions and say create function. And I'm going to say enemy death. All right. And then I'm going to take in a parameter. So this add parameter section here lets us add parameters to our function. And I'll explain what that means in just a moment. And I'm going to go ahead and say done. So what functions let you do is handle, have one place for your code that might need to run from multiple different locations. So this location here where we're destroying the enemy with a disintegrate effect, we want that code to run in both the collision with the player and when the health bar reaches zero. And the enemy that needs to be destroyed is different in each case. So in the case of the overlap with the player, the enemy that needs to be destroyed is this other sprite, because we are overlapping with an other sprite of kind enemy. And we pass that to the function as a parameter. So don't worry if that doesn't make too much sense. We'll get lots of opportunity to practice this. For now, you can just go ahead and do what I do. And in the status bar area, when the enemy health bar reaches zero, we want to take the sprite attached to that status bar and pass that to the call enemy death function. And then inside of the enemy death function, we take this enemy local parameter and drop that into this destroy block. So this connects all the pieces. So the other sprite from the collision is being passed to the enemy death function, and the sprite attached to the status bar that went to zero is being passed to the enemy death function. And then that enemy passed in is we're calling destroy with disintegrate on. So now we have one place to handle the death in our program. All right, so you can see now when I'm shooting enemies, they're actually disintegrating as well. Earlier, it was actually the case that the disintegrate effect wasn't being called when we shot down an enemy. All right, so now we have one place where death happens. Let's add a chance for a power-up. So I'm going to go to the logic category and drag out an if block. So if blocks let us run code if and only if a certain condition is true. So I'm going to go to the math category and drag out this percent chance. And I'm going to say that there is, for sake of testing, I'm going to make it kind of high, but I'm going to say there's a 50% chance that a power-up is going to be dropped. So we're going to add code in here for dropping a power-up. All right, so a power-up in our case is just going to be a sprite. And I'm going to go to the sprites category and drag out another create sprite block. And this one is going to be called power-up. Power-up. All right, and this is going to be, we're going to choose the kind for this sprite. And it's not really any of these. It's maybe you could think of it as food. But actually, I'm going to add a new kind, and I'm going to call that kind power-up. All right, so we've got a power-up of kind power-up. Let's draw that. I think I will, what color aren't we using? We're not using green much, so I'm going to draw a green here for power up, and you know, it's a pretty rough looking P, but that's okay. We don't need great perfect graphics in our game. Let me get rid of this bit in here. Okay, so we've got a P, and let's add a blue border around that. I'm going to use the fill tool to fill all that in. Okay, there's our power up. So now let's see what happens when we destroy an enemy. A power up appears, and it actually happens that power up was pretty close to where the enemy died. But see, this one that I destroyed, well, actually, there's only 50% chance. But so any power up that is created is being placed in the default position because we didn't do anything to set the position of this power up. So what we need to do is set the X position of the power up to the X position of the enemy. So in the sprites category, I use the set my sprite X block and the my sprite X block. So what this does is it sets the power up's X to this sprite's X. So X is the X coordinate, the X, the location horizontally of the sprite. And the sprite that we want to get the location from is the enemy. So drag this enemy local variable into the second spot here. So this is saying power up X to enemy X. Great. So that should align them on the X. And we want to do the same thing. I'm using Control C, Control V to duplicate that block, or Command C, Command V on a Mac. And I want to set the Y to the enemy's Y. All right. So now we should be dropping power ups at the location of the enemy's death. Great. So you can see it's not always. We got 2 out of 3 power ups there. And there's another one. And now when we collide with the power-ups, nothing really happens. So let's work on that bit. So I'm going to go to the sprites category again, scroll down until I see the on overlaps block. And I'm going to say when the player overlaps a, you can't quite see with my face in the way, overlaps a power-up, we want to run some code. So the code that we want to run is totally up to us. We could do all kinds of crazy things with power-ups. In this case, I think what would be nice is if our gun fired faster. You know, the enemies are ramping up in difficulty as time goes on. We saw that in one of the previous videos that I'll link below. But the player is not really getting any stronger. So let's have the enemy, the player fire faster. So what I'm going to do is put the player in double fire mode so that they fire twice every time you hit spacebar. And to start, I'm actually going to go find this projectile image that we drew for our laser, and I'm going to drag that out. By the way, any image in Arcade you can duplicate like this by just dragging it out. And any block you don't want, you can drag over here to this toolbox to get rid of it. Okay, so I've got this laser, and you'll see what I'm about to do with this in a sec. And I'm going to create a new sprite. Let's call this the double fire mode. Double fire mode. And you'll see why I have this visual here. So I'm going to drag that in there, click to edit it. And now we're editing a copy of the original image, not the one that is what we're firing. Okay, so I selected this using the selection tool, and now I'm going to hit Control C, Control V, or Command C, Command V on a Mac. And I'm going to drag that down. And now you see 2 of our little laser. And that's going to be sort of the indicator that we're in double fire mode. And I'm going to place this at the kind of top of the screen next to the health. So I'm going to drag out the set position block for this. So I'm going to say the double fire mode is going to be positioned at sort of the top of the screen right around there. So by the way, in the position block, you can click on this to set the position using this cursor. So this green border here represents the border of the simulator. So clicking here, you know, sets it to kind of that area of the screen. All right, let's see how that looks. So I'm gonna destroy some enemies, get a power up, and I overlap the power up, and you can see that we have this double fire mode appearing there, but it's sort of hidden behind the health. So I'm going to shift it over. So instead of 23x, I'm going to say something like, let's say 48x. So that should shift it out of the way of the health. Let's make sure that works. All right, so now we have this laser indicator to signal that we're in double fire mode. And let's make double fire happen. So I'm going to go to where we're firing, and that's on the A button pressed. So here on A button pressed, we shoot one projectile. And I'm going to say if there is a double fire mode indicator around, so you can actually just drag most variables inside of the if block. So to make the double fire happen, I'm going to select our single firing line of code and duplicate it into here. And now we're firing two projectiles at a time. So let's see if we can do that. So now in double firing mode, and you can actually see that the enemy health goes down twice as fast as it used to. Unfortunately, you can't really see the two different projectiles, and that's because they're laying right on top of each other. So when this projectile is being created right at the ship, this other projectile is being created at the exact same spot, and they're overlapping, and you're not really seeing that difference. So to see the difference, I'm going to shift one of them up a bit. So I'm going to go to the sprites category. I'm going to say change. And I'm going to say change the projectile Y position by, let's say, 10. So that's just going to shift it downward a little bit. All right, let's see how that works. So now I've got the power up, I'm in double fire mode, and you can see both projectiles now. All right, so I think 10 is a little aggressive. Let's have that. Let's say 5. And actually, let's move the other one up 5 as well. So I'm going to do -5. So now that they're no longer firing from the center of the ship, but kind of off on either side. And there, you can see that in action now. Cool. So we have this double fire mode. But one problem is that the double fire mode is sticking around for the rest of the game. And what I really want is actually the double fire mode to go away after a certain amount of time. Doing that is fairly simple. So where we create the double fire mode is in the player overlaps power up. And here I can use a special property on sprites called their lifespan. So I'm going to go to the set my sprite block, drag that out. And I'm going to say for the double fire mode, I want to set a certain property. And so we've seen lots of the physics properties like the X and the VX, things like that. There's also a property called lifespan that we can set. And this is the number of milliseconds that that sprite is going to survive for. So let's say 2 seconds would be 2000 milliseconds is going to be the lifespan of this double fire mode. So what we should see now is that after 2 seconds, the double fire mode should go away. And indeed, it did. The bullets are still firing, though, after the double fire mode went away. So why is that? So the reason why the double fire mode stays around even after the double fire indicator goes away is because what we're checking up above was that the double fire mode variable is set. And the variable will be set even if the sprite is destroyed. So to fix this, I need to not only check if double fire mode has been set, but I also need to check that the lifespan of the double fire mode is greater than 0. So I'm going to go to the logic category, and I'm going to drag out the AND block. I'm going to drag the double fire mode into one side. I'll drag the greater than symbol into the other side. And then I'm going to copy paste this double fire mode and go to the sprites category and drag out the property block here. And I want to say that the lifespan is greater than 0. So we're going to drag all this back into the if statement. What this is saying is if the double fire mode has been set at least once and the double fire mode's current lifespan is greater than 0, then we're in double fire mode. Otherwise, we're not. So let's see how this plays out. So here we go. Got my double fire power up. And you can see that once that power up goes away, we are back to a single bullet. All right, so there's something else that you might have noticed, which is that the power-ups actually aren't going away when we're picking, when we're running into them. So let's go fix that real quick. We just need to add a destroy block in this on overlap of kind power-up. All right, so we are almost there. Let's change the percent chance to much lower than 50% chance. Let's say 10% chance, and let's play our game and see how that goes. So we've got the spaceship firing away. Let's see if we can get a power up. All right, I sped up the video a bit there until we got a power up. Took a little while, and you saw I had the power up for a little while, and then I lost it. So I think actually we want to increase the duration that we have the power up by a little bit, since it takes a little while to be able to get a power up. So I'm going to say maybe 10 seconds, actually, a fair bit of time. So let's go down until we see our spawn power up code. And then we're going to set the lifespan to be 10 seconds, which is 10,000 milliseconds. One thing I forgot to do real quick is that when we create the double fire mode, we were setting it of kind player. Actually, what we want to do is have a new kind so that it's not going to run the same code that the player would. So I'm going to call this a mode kind. So when it was the player kind, what would happen is if an enemy ship ran into that indicator, we would actually lose life. And that's not what we want. All right, thanks for watching. This has been one way to add power-ups to your game. And I'm Daryl from MakeCode.